this is Leach 83. How we doing? Welcome to episode number 14 now of Celtic's Road to the European Cup in career mode FIFA 16. If you're new to the series, then please check out links in the description where you can find links to the playlist and you'll be able to see how we're going so far this season. Everything's going well. Now, at the end of the previous episode, I said basically because we are running away with the league, we would try and change up the team a little bit. And each game, what we'll be doing is just letting some of the different players get a game or two under the belts, some that haven't featured, the likes of Lustig, who's hardly played, Kieran Tierney, who's not really played much, the likes of James Forrest, who's been a bit part. We'll put them in to start this game, which is our next game, which is away to Dundee, which will be perfectly fine. Our new signings, the likes of Jack Grealish and Alexander Esswein, will stay in the team, and we'll get GM Daniel Thomas on the bench, should we need him. And that's what basically we're going to do, squad rotation from now on in before each game, and hopefully it just gives some of the kind of the youth players and what have you a chance just to get their opportunity should it come to them. So as I say, this game is away to Dundee. We've not had many troubles in the league before, so we shouldn't have any troubles again today. Three games in this episode. We'll be doing this one against Dundee, and then we'll get back-to-back games in against Kilmarnock, one in the league, and then we play them in the cup, and that'll be this episode. So we'll see how we go on these games, and hopefully we can just keep up our good performances. Oh my god. How that's getting is beyond me, but that's a goal for Dundee, and they take a 1-0 lead. Just seemed to be a ball out of nothing, and Kame Hemmings has managed to get on the end of it and stick it away. Just a ball from nothing, I don't know what the hell was going on there, but nonetheless. Chifchi having a run at them from kickoff. Chifchi! And that's a goal back right away. Right from kickoff, just had a straight run at them. They had no answer. Managed to just cut back a couple little fakes, and he's just managed to smash it away, and that will do nicely, one each. Well, there we have it, finished one each against Dundee. Probably we should have took more better of our chances than we came to us, but that's just one of those things, and I'll take that result because I've made some changes to the team, brought on 3 substitutes as well, just to try to change it up as well. And that's all, I'm kind of, as I said before, I'm just trying to get some game time for some different players, and we'll just keep doing it like that. Now, in regards of player development training, I'm just going to stick with my usual people that we've put in, but now I've changed it to Jack Grealish. He'll get some time doing some training, as well as Jozef Zinovic, Zinovic is away on loan, so Tyler Blackett, he was in for some defensive training, as well as Kieran Tierney, who will also get some defensive training. And then we'll put in our backup goalkeeper that we've just signed from the youth team, that's Eric Riley, and we'll put him in for penalty saves. And then finally we'll put in Zanui for some headers and volleys training as well, and see how they got on with that. Hopefully they'll do okay. Nope, somebody's failed. 2 fails, a fail for Tierney and a fail for Zanui. That's everything else is not too bad. Grealish getting an A, Blackett getting a D, and Riley getting a D also. So there's still progress, that's all that kind of matters. Now we'll just get ourselves sorted for our next game, which is against Kilmarnock in the league, and we'll see how we go for that one. Okay, so here's the team for the game against Kilmarnock. We've got Gordon in goals with Izaguirre, Boyata, Morrison and Yanko as our defence. Brown at centre defensive mid, and then we've got Grealish and Esswein on the wings with Mackay Stephen, and then up front we've got Griffiths and J. Emmanuel Thomas. So we'll see how we go in this game. Chifchi has been playing well, mind you, so I reckon that Emmanuel Thomas will only get half the game, and we'll be bringing Chifchi back on again, but we'll see how it goes. Well held up by Emmanuel Thomas. Oh, he's been pulled down. Emmanuel Thomas held up the ball for Mackay Stephen, and a bit of a nothing tackle again, and he's gave away a penalty. Nothing really in that at all, but I'm not going to complain, I'll take it. And we'll get Lee Griffiths with the chance to give us a lead. Bottom right. Oh, he's been saved. He's been saved, and it's out, God's sake. Well, won back by Brown. Looking for Emmanuel Thomas. Emmanuel Thomas, his first goal for the club. That'll do nicely. Nice ball from Scott Brown onto the big man, and he's managed just to hold off the defender and get it slotted away. And that'll do nicely. 1-0. It's a ball through for Kilmarnock. Tom Rogic on there on loan. Could he come back to haunt us? Tom Rogic. Oh, you wee dick. If he scored that, he'd have been dropped. He'd never play for us again. Out to Kilmarnock to get game time and almost fucking scoring against us. Judas. Oh my god. Are you serious? Give the ball away from the kick out. And it's a late goal for Ashcroft, I think it is. You can see Tom Rogic celebrating with them there. He's on loan at Kilmarnock. A stupid hit out. I don't know why I didn't just put it up the park. And we've paid the price, and it's 1-1. Well, another 1-1 draw, and that's just a calamity of errors from myself. Missing a penalty, and then also giving a ball out like that at the dying stages of the game. And it was their only shot on target, which was just stupid. It's just one of those things. So back-to-back 1-1 draws in the league, which doesn't set up very well for our next game, which is actually coincidentally against Kilmarnock again, but this time in the Scottish Cup. So we'll get our team ready for that, and we'll see how it goes. I'll try and put out probably a full strength team in this one, because I do want to win the Cup. Okay, so that's us ready for our Cup game against Kilmarnock. Back to a standard 4-4-2. We've got Tierney, Boyata, Duffy and Yanko, with Grealish, Mackay, Stephen, Brown and Eswine, and then Griffiths and Chifchi up front for us. Actually, just noticed I don't want to have, I'm going to put Azigiri back on instead of Tierney just now, just to give us a full strength back line. So we'll do that, and that'll be the team for the home game against Kilmarnock in the Cup. This is the quarter-final stage, so obviously want to progress into this. I do want to get as far as we possibly can. I want to actually win this Cup. I want a League and Cup double at least for the season, so that's the goal, and let's see if we can do it in this
Alexander
game.
Alexander Eswine, he's got Grealish on the overlap from the other side, and in the 86th minute, it's Jack Grealish. Jack Grealish, oh, he's fucked it wide. Unbelievable. Oh, how the fuck he should have buried that. Well pressed. Griffiths! Oh yes, that'll do nicely. Not the pleasantest of goals, but just pressed by Lee Griffiths. He's managed to win it back, and that's an 89th minute goal in the Cup. I tell you one thing, this game's been frustrating as hell. Really, really frustrating. We put us on full press, full attack, and we managed to get the ball in the back of the net. 1-0. Well, we made that harder for ourselves than what it should have been, but I'll take a 1-0 victory any day of the week. We had chance upon chance, well, not really chance upon chance, we had two shots on target, but it felt like we were pushing and prodding, but Kilmarnock were just really hard to break down in this game. But I'll take the result and we'll take the progress, that's all that matters at the end of the day, and puts us into the semi-final of the Cup, and we'll play the winner of of Partick Thistle and Hearts in the semi. So it should be a good game no matter who we get in that one. So what's basically going to happen now is we'll just get a quick review of where we are just now with everything, and let's see. Club talking about Marvin Elnes, that's fine. I'm not really bothered about that. Right, so basically we will end this episode here. We've got Hamilton Accies, then Dundee United, and then Aberdeen in the next game. And then it's basically the push to the end of the season. We've only got a couple of games left to play. Then there's the fixture split, I think, happens in this career mode. So we'll have that happening. And then we will then see who we get in the Cup and what have you as well, which we'll need to obviously progress in also. Everybody's doing okay. We're still top of the league. We're still doing no bad. And I'm enjoying putting different players into the team just to kind of give everybody a chance and what have you. We'll have a further look into whatever Mam and MDS was complaining about. And we'll basically try and keep everybody happy if we can. There's a few who are showing promise. There's a few who are showing a lack of like kind of creativity and what have you when they do get their chance. A lot of people are kind of down in the grumps and stuff like that because they're not playing, which is hard to kind of keep everybody happy when you're playing well at times. So it's one of those things. You just kind of got to kind of find a balance, and that's what I'm going to try and do as we progress through the rest of the season. But nonetheless, I've rattled on enough. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. If you have, then please drop a like as always. Any suggestions and comments, make sure you let me know what you think of it down below in the comment section. And I'll catch you in the next one. Take it easy.